特别好，所以等一下要用中文讲，用英文讲，所以稍微是用中文跟你讲，所以我想问 ，How many people are here for the 10 o'clock session, the Common Core? A lot of people here, Common Core, okay? Now Dr. Taylor talk about, you know, how to, you know, read. You got to read a lot, and we're gonna talk about how our superstars, what kind of books they read. To be honest, you don't have 18 years to catch up on reading. We'll show you a quick way to be very intellectual, okay? Because this is about solutions, and we as lawyers is to provide solutions, okay? Let's talk about our results first, because we have two basic objectives in our firm. Number one, 升学, college admissions. Number two, financial aid. Let's say if you don't need financial aid, you still need to get into good college. And here's our results. Because in this world, results count the most. Out of our top 50 students, 23 admitted to Ivy League, Stanford, MIT, Caltech, with Chicago, almost 50% into these great private schools. More, 3 Harvard, 4 Yale, 7 Cornell, with 15 USC, one I'm sitting there, Berkeley 25, Berkeley 21 UCLA. Okay. These are the results this year. We're very proud of these students. Yesterday, we had 6 of them coming to share their experience. Actually, one of them, Christine, is also coming back to share her experience too with the people who didn't come yesterday in the audience. So that's what we're proud of. And you probably got want to know how these students do it. 稍微学习吧，翻译。
大家都听得懂吧？我们其实我们的华人的父母哦，我们也不贪心，我们只是让小孩子进他该进的学校。那你的小孩子多大？
5年级，
太好了，这肯定上常春藤。OK， 大家给他掌声鼓励一下。所以呢？相信这位太太呢，这么早来，也就是展现我们父母的苦心，十几年来的努力，是不是就希望小孩子可以上大学？你看父母这么吃苦，都来了，对不对？你小孩几年级？11年级，对不对？十几年来的努力，现在我们干这个体力活，有没有再来再去？有，是不是？那现在我们要今天要教大家的是技术活，就是一个策略。我们十几年来的努力，我们喜欢赢在起跑点。可是这个，你看 SCA 五，还有常春藤，他有刚刚那个 Dr. Taylor 也讲过了，我们小孩子全部几乎都是 very competitive， 也就是成绩都非常好。
Dr. Taylor 不是说我不是 nothing special 吗
？We gonna make you special。今天我们要 make you special。
Okay,
所以今天 special 就是像我们这些小孩子一样，他们是 make their own URM。不管 SCA 五隐形也好，这个台面上台面下的 SCA 五，我们都会教大家怎么样可以打败 SCA 五。我们用律师的论证，待会儿我们再详细解说哦。那 SCA。
Okay。Everyone heard of SCA 5 right now, right? Something about don't let too many Asians into UCs. Some people even say it's a skin color act, okay? What does it affect the most? It affects the Asian students in California the most. Okay? If you're an international student, it doesn't matter because actually UC wants your money. They want $60,000 from you. If you can't study, that's too bad. They take the money and go for the next one. So it affects the UC students in the Asian students most. So how can we overcome that? Okay? So you have to understand education law and constitutional law. Okay? Basically, it's a little boring, but just this is something to remember. Okay? 14th Amendment Equal Protection Clause. What does it mean? Everyone has to be treated equally. Okay? That's something you can know. Before going a little bit too deep, I think we should have the students introduce themselves quickly first, okay? So let's just go to that point, okay? And so actually go over here. This student, I don't know if you guys know, got into all the Ivy Leagues, okay? All the Ivy, so I think that's a great accomplishment. That's a great job. So I think.
颜色一样吗？
很奇怪啊，那我们亚裔的 population 是占全美国 5%， 我们也是少数民族啊，那为什么我申请大学的时候会被排挤呢？因为我们的小孩子太好、太棒、太认真，父母太勤劳、太努力，变成我们是 over representative minority。
但是 Dr. Taylor 不是说 80% are qualified， so everyone are good。
要 compelling reason 让这些学校可以收，既然我们的颜色不是这样子。
So let's you know quickly kind of introduce some of our students. Actually, even they're not here, but they're represented by their parent. First, we have Austin Ouyang from Walnut High. He got to Rice, Berkeley, UCLA, and this a proud father here, Mr. Ouyang. Let's give the hand. Okay, and this is Mr. Ouyang, actually very tall and handsome. Okay.
His essay, 欧阳，我们要讲一下欧阳大侠的 essay。待会儿啊，一定要听。
Hey, next we have Alfred Moss. Also, he got to great school, Yale, Brown, MIT, U of Chicago. He was here yesterday. For those who came, get to all these great schools. We hope I didn't miss any. Cornell, Dartmouth, Brown. This is what he looks like. Very confident. He's going to visit Yale. Then he'll make a decision between MIT and Yale. It's kind of a tough decision. Don't you think, shall we say?Oh, very sweet, okay. So we'll meet him afterwards and see what he decides. Next, we have Kerry. Can you kind of introduce yourself? Is the name, high school, you know?
Hi, I'm Kerry Zane. I'm from Arcadia High School, and I am going to USC.
And in the middle is a proud father, USC father, Mr. Zhang.We'll hear from Mr. Zhang later. Mr. Zhang is a world-class singer. Okay, that's Kerry. Okay. Yes, Kerry. Okay. Next, we have Christina. Christina, quickly introduce yourself, please.
Hi, everyone. My name is Christina Chen. I'm currently a senior at Dynabar High School, and I will be attending Yale University next fall as a biomedical major. I'm probably going to the pre-med track.
And as you can see, Christina didn't just get in one school. She came to like Yale, Cornell, Dartmouth, Hopkins, Northwestern. Oh, okay, okay. Oh, okay. But we want crazy kids. Okay. 太棒太棒太棒 Super. And, you know, her mom is right there. Let's get...Behind every successful student is a proud parent. So today, I think we have to give parents all a big hand just for coming here. Okay, so we also have Derek. Derek's here yesterday from Walnut High. He got to Harvard and Yale. He's an excellent student, first of all, but he's also recruited for swimming. And later on, we'll talk about if you're...have a sport, you recruit it, you're 150% in. Not just 100%, 150%. Okay, Eric, this is our Mr. Stanford. Anybody from Irvine here or Beckman High here? Okay, Dr. Taylor in the previous session talked about what, we have read a lot of books. Our Mr. Stanford reads a lot of books. And we tell you what kind of books he reads, okay?Isaac was here yesterday, he's going to Harvard. Ivana was also here yesterday, she's going to Dartmouth, that's her, standing next to Mr. Ouyang. Josh, this is going from Walnut High to Berkeley, UCLA. He's the one who wrote about...
牛肉面。
Okay.
这边谁想来听牛肉面 essay? Okay.
Okay, we'll talk about that. And Simon also came here yesterday.He's going to Northwestern. The thing about Simon is he came to the United States only in seventh grade. He's only been here less than 5 years. And he's in... And that's our other... this is Tiffany from Northwood High, Irvine. She's going to Caltech. And Shannon can't be here today, but she's our Miss U Penn. Tiffany, that's Tiffany. This is the admission rate. So really hard, just like Dr. Taylor said, 80% of academic qualified, but obviously not 80% gets in. So how did it get in?
Let's look at the Stanford one, 5.1%.
Now, do you think Asians are higher? I'm special, I should be elite. I'm always above average, right? Okay, so, how do you make yourself special? This is what we try. So you SCA 5, basically, 反正对我们不利. So we have to have something to beat them.
我SCA5这个是不是被我们华人团结，结果被挡下来了，对不对？我们很努力的，可是 SCA5就像加州地震一样，它会再回来，会2016一定会再回来，那是不是会影响到我们？所以大家记得 SCA5就是像是平权法案一样，OK？
我听说已经好像回来了。
事实上，在 UCLA 今年录取的时候呢，事实上 UCLA 的 Chancellor 他写了，哇，那 UCLA 的 Representative 在这边。事实上呢 ，SCA5 隐形的已经慢慢在执行了哦，所以基本上呢，我们就记得平权法案，它是就像是 SCA5， 它是要保护以前被压迫的黑奴制度，所以你就记得。 SCA5就是平权法案，对亚裔不利 ，OK， 大家就这么想，对于非裔跟西裔是有利的。那怎么办呢？我们怎么样可以 overcome 这个 obstacle？
Of course, we can overcome with a what's called new URM. This is something you guys all need to know. Holistic approach. Anyone heard this term? What's a holistic approach? I think Dr. Taylor talked about last session. Holistic approach means they got to consider everything. A thing chai will talk, consider everything. But when they close the door, what's the first thing they look at? Race and ethnicity. Race and ethnicity. So how do you defeat that? How do you become this? Well, the best way is you are, what's the you are? Okay. Okay. This is the data to support this discrimination against Asians. 1990 to 2011, the percentage of Asian students in America went up from 20%, see this dotted line, to 40%. Only one school has kept up with the trend, Caltech. Every other school is like a 20% glass ceiling. Okay? So that's kind of very clear. That's some kind of quota. So the schools say, holistic approach, we consider everything. So how do we defeat this?
URM.
URM stands for underrepresented minority. Okay, Carrie, let me ask you a quick question. You apply to USC, is your race and ethnicity considered URM?
No.
Right, because that's top choice among Asians in Southern California, right? So how does Terry overcome that obstacle, overcome that URM? Okay? So you make yourself a URM. It doesn't need to be race or ethnicity. It could be activities, summer programs, okay? And let's actually find out a little bit more students about them. Okay, Carrie, you are the ASB president of Arcadia High. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Okay, well, as ASB president, I run the student activities of the school, and basically we plan events, and we also try to interact with students to better our campus.
Okay, who's here is from Arcadia High? Right, from Arcadia High. So, Carrie, how many students are Arcadia High?
It's around 3,900.
Okay, can anybody become ASB president?
No.
Is it easy to become president? Can I just like, I want to be president?
I think anyone can be president.
You have to be elected?
Yes, you have to be elected. Yeah.
Okay, so it sounds like it's going to be kind of competitive going against a lot of candidates. So So can you tell us how you managed to beat other competitors and become president?
Oh, well, there's an election process. So basically, we sign up if you want to run for a certain position, and then there's an election process, and it's actually going on right now for our school for next year. And you have to campaign really hard for the course of a month, and at the end of the month, we have the final election, and then the results are announced from there.
Okay, and now through your job as ASB president, you probably interact with like principal, the faculty, administration quite a bit. How do you think that experience have helped you grow as a person and a leader?
Oh, well, okay, as president, you have to talk to a lot of adults that you work with, a lot of the school administration, and it's helped me improve my skills in speaking maturely and speaking like an adult. And I've developed several different types of relationships. So I've developed horizontal relationships with my peers, basically being their friend, making a lot of new friends, and meeting a lot of new people. And I've also developed vertical relationships in talking to people that are superior to me. And I've become more proficient at talking to adults and administration.
Wow, she sounds like a lawyer. Does she talk like a lawyer? Talking like a lawyer. Okay, Gary, let's come back to you a little later. Let's find out a little bit more about Christina, okay? Now, Christina, even though you're not the ASB president of your school, but you get involved in a lot of activities also, especially summer programs. Can you talk about the summer program you participated last summer?
Last year, I had the opportunity to work at a research lab in Stony Brook University in Long Island. Through the Garcia Material Science Research Program, which is a 7-week program for high school students who are interested in scientific research, specifically in material science. And so, unlike other programs on the West Coast, where you simply just sit in a classroom and listen to lectures, in this program, students are actively conducting research with graduate students, undergraduate students, and even professors in a specific lab. And students aren't just, like I said before, learning from the teacher. They're learning actively inside the lab, conducting real research that hasn't been conducted before. And not only has this research experience exposed me to a different world of science, not just reading through a textbook, but also you meet other students from across the entire United States students. My research partner was actually from Seattle. And exposing yourself to these types of different people, like Carrie said, it's a new experience because you're not only interacting with your peers, but interacting with professors, with graduate students. And it is a different thing in that many times you don't have this opportunity to talk to people who are experts in their field. And being that if you're in high school and you're already conducting scientific research, it's a very different thing, and it puts you above your peers, especially in the West Coast. When scientific research in high school isn't actually focused upon, rather as in the East Coast, many students have the opportunity to conduct research because it is more emphasized. And so when you do have this research experience at a young age, it prepares you for college experiences, because in college, research is a big part of any student's life. Even if you're not a scientific major, even if you're an English major or a humanities major, research will be a very big part of your life. And this summer, I had the opportunity to conduct research again, this time on the East Coast at Stanford University, and I will be working on a biomedical experiment with a professor for 8 weeks. Thank you.
Okay, that was great. Let's come back to Carrie for 1 second. Actually, Carrie, through your work as ASB president, which involves many hours of extra work, I think you get to know your principal of your school, correct?
Yeah.
And then, am I right that he actually submitted a recommendation on your behalf to USC?
Yes, that's true. This year I've gotten the opportunity to speak to people at the school board, including the principal, and he and I have gotten a really close relationship. So he was able to write my recommendation for USC.
Okay, let's take this in perspective. You know, USC this year have an all-time low in admission rate. about 17%. And USC also does not require recommendation this year. Now imagine a school principal of 4,000 students submitted recommendation for Carrie here to USC. Do you guys think her chance of getting in a lot higher or lower? Charlie, what do you think?
是一个 hardworking, diligent. That's it? No, 他一定是讲说他是 very creative, good at communication.
And Carrie, since your principal sounds like a very nice guy, did he submit for all 4,000 students recommendations?
No.
Only for you, right? Probably.
Me and a few other awesome people.
Awesome people. See, that's how you can get into USC top school. Okay. That's how you can stand out.
所以呢, Carrie, 她是 from Arcadia High. So Carrie, 有多少 Arcadia High Asian population?
90%.
Probably 80%. 80%. 所以 Carrie 是不是 URM? 她不是, 是不是 underrepresentative minority? 是不是? 不是, okay? 那她申请 USC, 是不是很多 Asian? 她是不是 under URM? 也不是, 那 怎么样让他自己变成URM in her own way 呢? 是什么东西?
ASP President.
ASP President. 所以你看, 他是学生会的主席, 是4000人高中学生会的主席。 但是如果Carrie只是在他这个resume 或是一个list写说 他是学生会的主席, 那他在essay如果没有强力打这个, 他的这个URM, 也没有办法变成URM的 所以待会儿我们要讲 怎么样可以连接 Carrie 她是学生会主席 她是代表4000个学生 怎么样我们可以连到essay 这个范畴里面 所以呢 今天大家要带回去的 我们怎么克服隐形 或是台面上 台面下SCA5 你要成为自己的URM 很简单 我们在加州 我们的小孩都不是URM 我们申请UCLA 也不是URM 但是如果 比如说你搬到阿拉巴马去了我跟你保证小孩子上哈佛为什么区域性的URM OK 所以大家记得搬到Alaska 很少Asian的地方 你就是URM 既然我们要住在加州我们就要享受这个地震会常常来 所以今天大家来 就跟教大家怎么样让自己成为URM 下一个我们讲Christina 她怎么样变成她URM 一样 Summer Program
Okay, so we look at what each student have Whatever you have, we try to make it even better Okay, Summer Programs, your extracurricular activities And we don't list them We go through an essay, later on go through the essays And or sports Sports yesterday, we had someone from Walnut High, Derek. He's being recruited by Harvard and Yale. So coach approached him, but it's not as easy. We have to teach him what to say to the coach. Okay, what do we say to, we gotta be very humble. Okay, we gotta act like very, professional. You gotta write like a lawyer, write a lot of emails to the coach. You can't just say, you can't sound like not intellectual because that's not what they're looking for. They're looking for student athletes.
OK，所以呢，这个就是讲要让自己变成一个URM。那我如果说也来不及运动怎么办？运动永远是一个最快速道路，来不及跑步。我们有一本书叫《教育柔道》，教大家怎么运动。所以在座有没有九年级以下的学生家长啊？有没有？OK，focus on 运动，这是美国文化。来不及的就继续听reading， 还有essays。 90、11年级的运动来不及啦，跑步来不及，游泳来不及，怎么办 ？Read outside the classroom， 就像刚刚那个 Dr. Taylor 讲的一样，你要 read outside， 比如说要念哪一种书呢
？We suggest non-American, non-British authors， 非英国，非美国 ，Why？ 美国跟英国的 author， you read it in school。 Even for schools like engineering school like Caltech, they ask you, what are the three books you read? Favorite books? Best answer, non-American, non-British author. Okay, one of our students, that's what she answered. Okay. So let's actually go through some essays. That's what everyone's waiting for, right? What these top three, what kind of essays, okay? First, this is Tickle, okay? This is from Alfred. Alfred, see, he's the guy who's debating MIT and Yale. That's a very hard choice, right? Oh, okay. So why do we say do this, okay? Everyone apply to, you know, these top schools, they're hardworking, okay? Everyone's hardworking. If they see on essays say hardworking, you probably don't want to keep on reading. So he say, I come from a world, Suku. Okay, if you don't understand Chinese, you guys say, oh, what's that? That sounds interesting. If you want to keep on reading.
就是说, 所以呢,这个小孩子的 nickname, maybe 在那个, admission committee, 就是说, the 吃苦 guy. 所以我们一定要让我们的小孩子 stand up, 在座的父母, 我们都吃过苦, 是不是? 现在我们要把我们华人的吃苦文化写在里面, 这个就是 super food. Instead of 说, 哦,我们的小孩是 hardworking, diligent, 我们如果换一种方式写的话呢, 这个人家才会记得。
下一个，牛肉面，给肖律师你讲吧。事实上哈，我们这个万里啊教育法律集团哦，我们这个小孩子来呢，我们就会说你最喜欢的东西，你最不喜欢的东西，我们在这边呢就可以找到在日常生活琐事我们可以写出来的。 诶，那个小孩子来的时候说，我们家的牛肉面很好吃，我常常帮爸爸做牛肉面。 诶，你会不会觉得说我家牛肉面好吃？你家牛肉面不好吃吗？有什么稀奇嘛？是不是？牛肉面就牛肉面，我们天天在吃的。好，下一个。那刚开始就是说，诶，这个牛肉面呢，帮着爸爸煮，帮着妈妈煮，揉面条，蹲啊蹲啊蹲，是不是就好吃了？那可是大家想想看咯，你吃牛肉面的时候是白色面条，有没有像是美国的星条旗，白色的？ 然后呢，我们牛肉面是用什么蹲？八角，八角是不是像星星？所以呢，就是代表说，哎，他们家的传统在 July 4的时候是吃牛肉面，就好像是我们是新一代的移民，我们是第二代的移民，就像牛肉面，我们保留我们传统的文化，那我们渐渐融入美国这个文化大熔炉。所以呢，这家的这个就叫做 Beef Noodle Soup。 那姓刘，所以叫老刘牛，怎么念啊？老刘牛肉面。掌声鼓励一下，念的比我还棒哦。好，所以呢，我们今天跟大家讲说，我们日常生活的琐事呢，都可以写进我们的 essay。我们下一个讲说我们的中文名字。因为我们
Chinese culture, okay, a lot of Caucasians think, hey, all the Chinese are the same, all the Asian are the same. Well, 把我们的 you know, subculture especially 讲出来, so you can think about our essay style is like you know celebration of Chinese culture. Sometimes we see students just go too much Americanize their essays. Sometimes that doesn't work very well because look at the names. Xiaolisi, how many John Kim, John Chen, David Lee's out there? Everyone's essay is like too Americanized. The first name, last name, you know, even I get confused with our own students. So you try to make it something different. And we have three criteria for our essays. Number one, visual. Number two, you know, not metaphor. And number three, philosophical. And that's the most important thing. You gotta make it philosophical to make it sure that you sound very, you know, mature. If you just list your activity, you know, as the, you know, ASB president, I developed my leadership skills. You know, they see it too many times. Nobody's going to read the second sentence.
所以呢，事实上这个我们一定要掌握一个这个重点哈。我们的小孩子啊，万事俱备，只欠东风。这个东风是什么？是什么 ？Essay，OK， 是 essay。Essay 是可以最可以展现我们不一样的地方。 OK， 有多少个 Alan 梁，有多少个 Winnie 肖，有多少个 Sharon 王，是不是？所以呢，我们一定要在 essay 的时候展现我们不一样的地方。下一个，我们讲一下中文名字。我是永亮，这篇呢让我特别感动。为什么？因为呢， 这个当我们父母在取名字的时候，是不是在出生的那一刻就希望他永远光亮、永远聪明？就像这个梁律师的爸妈梁万里，就希望他前程万里；就像我的父母叫肖惠丽，希望我智慧又美丽，是不是？所以呢，今天真的是特别感人哦。
所以呢，小孩子也可以取名校奖金哦。所以这个我是永亮哦。事实上，这个我们这个中文名字可能在美国一辈子都用不到，可能就是在中文学校用到，或是祖父祖母会叫而已。但是呢，我们今天跟大家讲，你在申请大学论文的时候一样用得到。这个就是刚刚梁律师所说的 metaphor， 你用自己的名字来讲自己，你不用讲说我是永远光亮。 怎么讲呢？比如说，他在 orchestra 是属于动态的，在闪光灯下是不是很光亮？接下来呢，又是在 taekwondo 也一样，闪光灯 follow 他的一举一动，所以连接到他将来要读的也是属于 intellectual light。
And this is how we make it kind of philosophical at the end. Brightness would be always part of me. After all, that's the literal meaning of my Chinese name. Okay, that's how we tie it up together.
所以呢，就是有头有尾，然后中间呢，这个是我们万里的名牌设计哈。小孩子来，其实成绩都不错，都非常好，都有 activity， 都有中文名字，也都吃牛肉面。怎么样 make it stand out？ 也都读书。好，我们下一个。 我们讲，我是一个小白球，这个小孩子打高尔夫球哦，当然啦，你打高尔夫球很难展现出你是汗水流，很难。但是高尔夫球呢，就像人生一样，有没有一杆进洞啊？很难，对不对？所以呢，我们一样用这个高尔夫球是一个 metaphor 来展现出他打高尔夫球体会这个整个人生的历程。 好，所以呢，这一天呢也是非常非常经典的哦。那这个小孩子则进了Dartmouth，所以呢，你打任何的运动，或许没有办法到 recruit 的范畴，但是一定要写进来。Okay,
in the first sentence, this is where we go. On a recent afternoon, I flew over pristine manicure lawns over rolling hills with some of the best views of the ocean. If only I were a golf ball. So it's always beginning, very, very visual. Attract the student, attract the reader in. Okay.
Well,去年呢，有来听过我们讲座的，有没有听过我们讲座？有没有听过上海人的？有没有？没有哈。那有没有听过东北人的？我们这个中华民族有几个少数民，有几个民族？56个。 很多可以写的哦，所以去年呢，我们写一个上海人，这边有没有上海人的？没有吗？上海人可以进哈佛哦。<笑>上海人呢说，哎，你从哪里来？你会不会说你从国内来？你一定会说我是上海来。为什么？因为很 proud， 对不对？因为可以 walk on water， 所以你要讲说自己很棒，小孩子很棒，你不用讲说我多棒，你就想说我可以 walk on water， 所以一样，这是一个 metaphor。 那东北人是一个骑马的战士，他可以讲说他是 intellectual， 有非常有智慧的，所以呢，展现出一个文武双全的一个我们的华人的少数民族的特色。他们以为我们 Chinese 就 Chinese， 事实上我们 Chinese 有很多。反正你是如果是东北来的，你就说你是骑马的战士。还有呢，我们去年有个西安人也是进了哈佛，今年呢，我们这个讲，这边有没有台湾人？苏怡是什么意思？ 漂亮，对不对？漂亮可爱，所以我们这个就是属于漂亮可爱的海绵宝宝。那大家知道台湾是一个岛国文化，它是像海绵一样吸收，所以这个小孩子就用妈妈是从台湾来的这种岛国文化，能够多方吸收的这种特色展现出来，自己也像海绵一样。所以大家有没有看到，讲自己很容易接受新知识？ 怎么讲？要讲用别的东西来形容。欧阳，欧阳，哦
，Let's talk about 欧阳 first and come back. Oh, no, reflection falls down some mirrors first. Okay, this is actually an essay for Carrie here. Okay, So Carrie, why do we use this title, Reflection of 4,000 Mirrors?
I use this title because the mirrors represent, the 4,000 mirrors represent the 4,000 students that the ASV president is meant to represent, and saying that I am the image, the physical embodiment of these 4,000 students.
Yep. And so we start with, I come from the world of 4,000 mirrors. Shall we say, is that kind of mysterious? Or as compared to, I'm the ASB president of Arcadia High. So it's a little mysterious. You want to keep the reader keep on reading the second sentence. Okay? So instead of saying, so one of the techniques we say is show but not tell. So instead of saying, I'm the ASB president of Arcadia High, and therefore I gain a lot of leadership skills. That's way too common. We say, I come from the world of 4,000 mirrors, and through those mirrors, I represent, I embody the student's spirit, I represent them. That's much more visual and philosophical.
同时呢,也展现出来说, 4,000 mirror就表示你的一举一动, 有4,000个mirror在照着你, 也展现出来说, Carrie觉得他的责任很重大, 所以就变成他变得很humble, 他要每天怎么样?照镜子, 是不是? 是不是要看自己多漂亮? 不是, 要看自己怎么样? 是不是真的可以代表4,000个人, Arcadia High学生的一举一动? 所以给人家感觉, 这个小孩子责任重大, 又humble, 又反省, 但是这个title又这么的, 像侦探式的小说, 这个就是Carrie, 他可以进这个USC, 因为他这个essay就是变成他自己的URM。
So let me ask you something, 肖律师. So I couldn't say I'm a responsible person in the essay?
可以这样写吗? 也不能讲 hardworking吗?
I'm hardworking responsible. Better to say reflections of 4,000.
所以呢，大家一定要找一个 metaphor， 这就是 metaphor， 一个形容的东西，然后连接自己，这样子的话，你的 essay 才非常非常有趣。那我们下一个，我们讲这个欧阳大侠。那我们华人呢，通常比如说我是肖，我是单姓，欧阳是复姓。 是不是? 那一般来讲呢，欧阳是比较少的。 那是不是欧阳变成是 I have four names， 我有4个名字。 这个就是我们今天讲欧阳大侠哦。那欧阳大侠呢，是我们中国人的复姓。那我们是从这个其实这个欧阳的爸爸在这边哈，在最左边那个哦。所以呢，我们希望就是说我们的 last name 能够带给我们小孩子申请论文的时候一个启发。比如说呢，这个我们是在李安这个《卧虎藏龙》这部电影来的。比如说有人的地方就有江湖，是非常险恶的。那有欧阳的地方，就永远是有大侠存在。所以这个欧阳呢，在我们的感觉上看金庸小说都是属于行侠仗义，都是见义勇为。不仅是这样子，欧阳还是文武双全呢。 有没有听过这个欧阳修、欧阳询？他们是文学家跟书法家，所以这整篇呢是属于小品文章，文化上那个趣味，一个写作的技巧就完全展现出来了。可是到最后又要 tie in 他这个上 college 的事情啊，我们看最后这个他怎么 tie in 呢？ 说，哎，这个最后结尾的时候就是说，我欧阳大侠，我以后在上大学的时候要行侠仗义。如果有人需要 carry luggage， 他一定会去帮忙；如果有人需要 tutor， 他一定会帮忙。所以呢，这个帮忙搬行李，就是像我的ancestor， 我的祖先一样，在江湖上是行侠仗义，只不过他现在在校园里面要行侠仗义。 所以有那种文武双全的感觉，所以呢，这个我们的名字一样可以写得非常非常棒的一个短篇的一个小品文章，这个就是我们外文的特色，你的名、你的姓，我们都可以让你发挥变得非常非常有特色。
Yeah, so that means, you know, we like to do this because then the parents, 祖先也觉得有小孩子的贡献. So this is a family victory. So let's give all the young family a big hand. But that's not it. 还有 another essay from Ouyang, 我要解释一下. Okay, it's a bridge for babies.
这个title是不是有点可爱？And
since you know Mr. Ouyang, you know our student is not here today, he I was going to ask him to explain. Basically, he participated in a summer program last summer. He, as part of that program, he has to design and build a bridge with spaghetti weighing no more than 250 grams, about 9 ounces, like half a pound. So they won the competition, the 9-ounce spaghetti bridge. Is that right, Mr. Ouyang? 9-ounce spaghetti bridge held a total of 90 pounds. 90 pounds, okay, spaghetti bridge. So we say, at the end, we found that, okay, we wonder as a bridge could shoulder the weight of a baby. At the end, we say, we found the answer. If we put 9 10-pound babies on our bridge, it would have helped. So it's very, very visual.
所以你看哈，这个欧阳行侠仗义。 然后呢，写这个 A Bridge for Baby 这么可爱的 title，他是在念 engineering 的。那里面呢讲的事实上全部都是属于他们工程上的一个用怎么用 spaghetti 造这个桥，但是我们用非常非常 cute 的 title 把它 tie in 出来，让人家觉得会会心一笑，同时也知道说哇这个小孩子他是要学工程的。那 大家会不会记得我欧阳大侠，然后 A Bridge for Baby， 你马上就 stand out 了 ，just by 你的 essay 的 title。所以在这边呢，大家一定要带回去的，写 title 就是你上名校一个重要重要的一个捷径。Okay,
let's go back to see what about Harvard students do the books they read. Hey, pushing for change. Okay, yesterday was Isaac. Has anyone heard of an author named Alexander Pushkin? 中文怎么讲? 普希金? 普希金. And he's one of the great authors of the 19th century. Okay. So actually Isaac knows Russian. He read the book in Russian. So we say, okay, let's just play your strength. Just keep working on it. So we compare civil rights movement of Russian to America and make a comparison. So that shows that he knows, he's very, very intellectual. Coupled with the fact that he knows Russian, he reads these books, Feiying or Feiming, well, that pushed him over the edge. And, yeah, what did you say?
所以呢,这个是我们外面的王牌设计,从这个普希金连到马丁路德,你去查 Google,没有人这么连,可是哈佛就喜欢,这个是属于比较深的民权运动哦。 那当然就是说呢，很多就是属于像写 essay， 你也可以变成自己的 URM。所以大家今天要带回去的就是说，第一个我们有法律保护的 URM。你如果是属于中低收入，如果是单亲，那如果你是运动员，基本上你成绩好，你就是属于特快道路。 第二个是相对优势的 URM， 比如说我们的小孩子，如果是在加州的男生，如果跑去外州念文理学院的话，那你就是属于区域性的 URM， 因为90%的小孩子想留加州。那如果说想像 Carrie 这样子，我又想留加州，我又是 Arcadia High 这么多 Asian， 又申请 USC。 这么多 Asian 地方，那你就创造自己的新 URM， 想让小孩子留加州的举手，不想吗？想留加州对不对？就今天带回去创造你自己小孩子的新 URM， 借由什么？借由 reading， 借由 essay 是可以做得到的啊！所以创造自己新 URM， 这一定要带回家。And
one more。 Apply early. Okay, early decision, early action. A lot of students worry about applying early decision. It's binding, they're afraid to do it. But if you go to a school like Arcadia High, Diamond Bar High, so competitive, you have to cut in line. You have to apply early. That's how you cut in line. It's too much of material for us to go into detail. A lot of people worry about applying early, it's binding, but we'll show you the way out of out. Basically, if you apply early decision, you have to apply financial aid. If the financial aid is not enough, you can back out.
下一位是一位quick的解释一下。就像买房子一样，这边在座都有买过房子嘛，对不对？如果你买房子的时候，如果贷款贷不出来，如果 appraise value 没有办法到了，那你要买吗？不可以。但是卖方可以随便退出来吗？不可以。所以是不是像学校也像卖方一样 ？Early decision， 大家知道 admission rate 是特别高的，对不对？ 你看都是 double 或是 triple， 所以呢，你们今天来，如果有11年级的，有没有11年级的家长？11年级，你们今年11月1号一定要申请 early， 不要害怕。从 statistic 统计上看来呢，申请 early 绝对是录取率高的不得了，不要害怕，因为呢，如果被绑住，你就申请 financial aid， 钱够不够？他不可能给你65000的。 永远可以说不够的啊，所以一定要申请啊 early decision.
Okay, so again to review, apply early, okay, become your URM, books you read, non-American, non-British, essay, look at what you have, make it a hook. So it'll be URM. Of course, you have sports, then use it. Whatever you have to use it. Okay, let's quickly review and ask actually the students, first of all, Carrie, to give last minute advice to the student audience. A year ago, Carrie, you were just a kind of nervous junior, kind of reflect upon your journey, and what kind of advice you want to give to the juniors, sophomore, freshman in the audience.
Okay, my advice to the juniors, sophomores, freshmen in the audience is to do what you love to do, and find those activities that you're really passionate about, because that's where you'll excel and do really well, and you can really write about that really well in your essays or talk about it in interviews for college. And yeah, just do what you love and do your passions and start early. Start your applications early. It really helps, and then it makes it a lot easier for you to progress. Thank you.
Yeah, and one more question, Terry. What is your major at USC?
Oh, my major is public relations.
Okay, so there you go. This is what you like to do, right? Okay, thank you. Okay, Christina, can you give some advice to the students in the audience?
I would just like to alliterate what Carrie just said. It's really important to do what you love, because it's the college application process, it does not end when you get accepted into the college, because life goes on after that. It goes off into medical school, it goes off into graduate school, and it's important to find something that you truly love so that you can immerse yourself into it. And again, it's when you apply to colleges, it shows through your essays and it shows through your interviews. And college admission officers are trying to put a face onto the application. They don't want to just read an ID, or they want to see the person behind the ID number. And having something that you're really passionate about will really help you stand out from other students. And so, good luck.
我们今天来呢，给大家30分钟一个一对一律师的免费约谈。在这个表格有没有看到？大家有一个小 brochure， 如果没有的话，待会儿可以上二楼右手边我们的 booth 那边拿。这个你把你的 email 填写清楚，还有你的 location， 你 prefer 的，特别是 email 哦。 我们会有一些常常有一些 update 的 news 给大家，在这边有没有在我们的 emailing list 里面的有没有？管不管用？管用哦，所以呢填下来，我们绝对会让你最新的申请学校奖助学金的一个趋势哦。那我们1点呢会在我们二楼小教室那边，那我们这些巨星。 还有爸爸妈妈可以跟大家面对面讲一下他们的心得分享，那比如说呢，我们刚刚讲哦，我们有一个 Education Judo 这本书，这本呢你就看一下这个你的族裔在哪一个学校，既然你不想搬到阿拉巴马，但是你要找一个学校你是属于 URM 的，那我们这本书会教你你怎么样可以变成自己的 URM。那我们还有一本是 Writing Like a Lawyer。 比如说呢，我们在写作上面呢，像刚刚那么多的好的 essay， 是不是我们用律师的写作公式教给大家，为什么写作就没有公式呢？今天我们教大家，写作是有公式的。如果呢，你学这个公式下来的话，你就可以带着写作工具箱，就可以上大学，甚至以后工作你都不用愁怎么写了。我们这本书是写给9岁到99岁在场的爸爸妈妈，如果将来你对 SCA 5有反弹的话，你就可以写得像律师一样啊。这本呢，我在我们 booth 二楼那边也有卖啊。那我们现在呢，请一下我们这个Pro Parent 讲一下这个，给大家一个简短的一个心得，好不好？因为父母很焦虑的，对不对？来。
Hello， 哎呦，我不知道这个维尼，他不仅是一个教育学家，他还是一个表演家。哇塞，这是说话流利，形象好看，口气迷人，简直是不得了。非常高兴，也非常荣幸哈。我到这儿来，怎么给我抓到台上来了？非常高兴，我是 Carrie 的爸爸，我叫阿斯克张。所以我觉得Carrie 跟我的儿子，我还有一个儿子，他在现在在 Berkeley 化学系那他们每个孩子，这两个孩子呢，在他们上小学五年级毕业的时候，我开车载他们回家，我跟他们说，你们愿不愿意跟爸爸 promise？ 他们说 promise 什么？那是不是要买礼物？我说不是，那个 promise 我从今天开始起，一直到将来，你们在学校是一个 good student， 在家里是 good kid， 一个好孩子，在学校是好学生，在家里是好孩子。那我跟你妈妈呢，一个是唱歌，一个是弹琴，搞起这些数字来，就化学呀什么乱七八糟的搞不清楚哈。你们自己呢，看着办。然后我儿子说，爸爸什么事看着办？我说看着办的意思就是说你自己决定，你将来要做好学生呢，去自己可以生存，自己可以养活自己，自己做自己喜欢做的。然后他们俩就说可以，是吧？我说好，那么只有两条路，一条路呢是像那些个已经大的哥哥姐姐们，像他们读个比较好的学校，读你喜欢的东西。那另外一个呢，你们看见的街上的 homeless 就像他们那样，要不然你们就去吸毒，就这两条路。那么一个是进监狱，一个是上天堂，那你们自己选择。爸爸就不多管不多问，是吧？所以他们还不错， very good。 很高兴非常高兴。这个我现在呢，我是一个歌唱家，我有一点难过，也有点嫉妒哈。你们这个所有的学校，所有教育，所有的 program talk about 这个 student talk about school， 你们从来没 talk about 这个好的艺术学校，是不是？我们对我们，我也要提出 SCA 5，对不对？那我跟他妈妈是毕业在西北大学的音乐学院。那我是先读了芝加哥的音乐学，然后到了这个 Yale， 到了西北，然后到了耶鲁，然后到了纽约，然后到了茱莉亚音乐学，然后又读纽约电影学院。这个我是茱莉亚音乐学院毕业，我是唱歌剧的，是吧？所以对教育不是很灵，所以我只能跟他们说，要不你去监狱，要不你去好学校，你自己选，你知道吗？所以非常高兴。我觉得Dr. 梁他在对这个孩子，对这些孩子们的教育上他有一种特殊的魅力和特殊的方法我觉得他们在工作上，他们非常的细腻，是吧？有一个伟大的导演，有人问他说，如果我想做一个好的作品，我应该注意什么？这个大导演说呢，你应该注意的并不是大家都注意的，而你应该注意的是别人没有注意到的细节，细节 再细节，就像买房子 ，location 再 location。那么在工作起来呢，在检查你的工作的时候呢，那就是说认真、认真再认真。我觉得他们夫妇俩，这一点做得非常的，与其他的教育的机构、教育的学校不同。他并没有逼着孩子说你一定给我背什么，你一定或怎么样。他们很谦和，他也没看上去那么牛，是不是？但是他们教学效果非常好，而且他是针对每个学生，你自己家的孩子，他对针对你的学生经过了解，他了解的首先是他的心理，然后是他的才华，然后是找到针对他找到了方法来给他。我觉得这个是非常难得的一个教育家，这我觉得很感谢他们，也非常感激他们。
唱一首歌感谢一下。
没有白吃的午餐。上台来原来就这样啊，对，所以很高兴。我觉得你们应该跟他，我觉得还有一个问题，我想告诉大家，就是说什么叫做文化意识的思念，思维和艺术手法的效果。一定要学会这一个啊，文化意识的思维会让你的孩子在长期的鉴定中培养出他的一个气质，而他这种气质是他得到最好最优惠的未来他想得到的理想的途径，最近途径啊。非常非常感谢，谢谢谢谢谢谢大家。现在有一个节目刚刚开的，在国际卫视，我现在现任国际卫视艺术总监。那我刚做了一个节目，做了一个节目，就是告诉我们所有在美国的华人，美国的文化是什么，近代的文化，美国的经济发展，它为什么会抢先称霸于世界，就是关于66号公路的故事是怎么起源，为什么建设高速公路，这都跟美国的文化的息息相关。那美国66号公路呢，叫 Mother Road， 啊，它是母亲路，所以我有一个秀，5月5号，每天11点开始播放啊，每天重播，就是奥斯卡秀，讲话说66号，里边有说有唱，还有这个还有戏，好看，非常好，免费的电台44.6。天线的啊，44.6，你们去看好不好？好，那很好哈、那我们就唱一首歌献给我们伟大的教育家，好不好？大家，那我们就唱一个《在那遥远的地方》，好不好？
好。
在那遥远的地方。
寻找后面的那只推手，
这支推手绝对是超过爸爸妈妈专业的能力。奥斯卡再能唱，他也没办法教孩子怎么样去申请大学。我再能够养孩子，我再能够开车去买最好的菜、最好的东西给孩子，我还是没有办法帮孩子申请最好的大学。所以呢，后面这支推手，在座的所有的家长，我觉得大家都可以张开你的眼睛，回家好好思考，并且做好比较，你的孩子一定有别人没有的亮光。我们做父母的最主要的功能，就是帮孩子找到最好的推手，把他的亮光放到最正确的地方。而且这支推手非常重要，要正确的速度，正确的方向。就像刚奥斯卡分享的，不能牛，我们台湾人学不到牛的意思。我希望待会再请教他一下，牛到底在中国话的意思，它的这个分界在哪里。但是呢，鼓励父母，你的努力今天绝对值回代价。我们让孩子的推手放在一个正确的位置，是你今天付出辛劳该回去做的功课。分享给大家，祝福大家。
我们听一下欧阳大侠爸爸怎么讲。
我也不快，一定会快。我原来没有打算讲话，但是我觉得我应该讲一下。我家有双胞胎哈 ，Austin， 他有一个 twin brother。我要讲的就是 Austin 呢，他参加了那个外语的那个 program， 他十二年first semester 他念得很清楚，因为他的 college application 都已经弄得很好。但是弟弟呢，他弟弟跟哥哥性格完全不一样，是 too extreme。 所以呢，弟弟说 I don't need help, I can do it myself。 但是后来他跟我讲了一句话， Dad, I regret not coming to this book。 谢谢。
我想起来林肯一个故事啊，现在这个对您要走您就走，我自己走。那个林肯的故事，有一个人说，他爸爸说，哎，你这个孩子真笨，你看人家林肯多棒，人家林肯做总统了，你看你这个成绩怎么也上不去，啪把他孩子妈的抽死，然后他爸爸还在这嘟了半天，你嚷嚷，你嘟囔什么？你说真了。我说什么？我说你别生气，我不生气，你说吧。你还说呢，爸？人林肯四十岁当总统了。
好，谢谢
爸，四十八了。
谢谢大家。哎啊、，So thank you for coming. Just remember, results is most important. OK， 前程万里，大家。
好，希望大家我们的小孩子能够克服 ACA 五，能够克服常春藤这个隐形的 ceiling。我们一定要用高等教育法的策略，让他们进该进的学校。下午一点钟呢，我们在二楼旁边的小教室，我们会面对面继续分享这些的经验啊、哦！谢谢大家，谢谢。